Welcome students in the virtual class organized by Stars Sudden. Yesterday in the previous class we have started factorization of different process of factorization, and today we are going to continue this type of factorization also. In the there is a form of factorization, form of factorization a square minus b square. Many more questions are there in the form. First of all, question is x square minus y square plus 2y minus 1. How can we solve it? This factorization is also depend upon this, but we have to recognize among these four terms, which three terms are interrelated? First of all, there is y square, 2y and 1. They are interrelated. Look here, x square, first of all, take minus common from here. Y square minus 2y, this is plus 1. Check it. Y square plus 1 square minus formula 2, it means y 1, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square, it means it is a perfect square. X square minus, this is y minus 1 whole square. Now it is in the form of a square minus b square, right? So we have to write a plus b, x plus b means y minus 1. A minus b, it means x minus b minus b, b means y minus 1. And this is to be sign of these two are to be multiplied with this sign, the minus y minus minus plus 1. Depend upon this form, there is another question. A square plus 4b square minus 4ab minus 4c square. Among these four terms, first of all, we have to determine that which three terms are interrelated to each other. Look here, these three terms, a square, b square and 4ab, it means these three terms are interrelated to each other. Look here, first of all, write a whole square, and this is plus 2b whole square. Next is minus formula 2. A means a, b means 2b. A square minus 2ab plus b square. It means 2 to the 4ab is there, minus 4ab. It is completed. Minus 4c square. It means what? It is in the perfect square form. It means a minus 2b whole square minus 2c whole square. It is now it is in the form of a square minus b square, so it will be a minus 2b plus 2c and a minus 2b minus 2c. Next question is, third question, to clear the concept over here, x4 minus 4y4 plus 4y square z square minus z4. Yes, among these four terms, which three terms are interrelated over here? Just we have to recognize it. Look here, there is y square and here is y4 and here is z4. There is y square and z square. It means these three terms are interrelated. Look here, x to the power 4 minus, first of all, take minus common from these three terms. 4y4 minus 4 y square z square plus z4. Look here, x4 minus, it is 2y square whole square plus z square whole square minus 2 into 2y square into z square. 2 to the 4y square z square is there, it means it is a perfect square. So it is x square whole square minus 2y square minus z square whole square. Right? Yes. Next is, or now it is in the form of a square minus b square. It means x square plus 2y square minus z square. And next is x square minus 2y square plus z square. It is in the form of this one. Next is, factorization of the form x square plus bx plus c. First of all, b is equal to p plus q. Suppose b is, here is b is equal to p plus q and c is equal to p into p into q. Here is, think two numbers whose sum is b. Think two numbers whose sum is b, and product of that both two numbers is equal to c is only, then the factorization is only possible. Suppose here is p plus q is equal to 7 and p into q is equal to 2. Checking, look here, 1 plus 6 is equal to 7, right? And 1 into 6 does not equal to 2. So it is not possible. Next is, 2 plus 5 is equal to 7 and 2 into 5 is equal, does not equal to 12, right? 3 plus 4 is equal to 7 and 3 into 4 is equal to 12. Yes, it means sum and product both are to be matched. Look here, then p plus q, sum is 7 and product is 12, both are matching. So p is equal to 3, q is equal to 4, or p is equal to 4, q is equal to 3. Like this we have to do. Suppose here is p plus q is equal to minus 4 and pq is equal to minus 12. How can we find out p and q? Look here, one minus 5 is equal to minus 4 and 1 into minus 5 does not equal to minus 2. Is it? Next is 2 minus 4. Next is here minus 6 plus 2 is equal to minus 4 is here and minus 6 into 2 is equal to minus 2. This is matching. Yes. So p is equal to minus 6, q is equal to 2, or q is equal to minus 6, p is equal to 2. Like this, you can do the solution. Next step is this type of factorization is called first into last. Look here, suppose there is a question x square plus 8x plus 12. It means what? According to this rule, we have to find out two numbers whose sum is 8 and product is 12. Whose sum is 8 and product is 12. How can we find out? First of all, here is 12 and here is 1. 12 and What is the coefficient of x square? 1. It means 12, 1's are 12 is here. Factorize it. 2, 6. 2, 3. Right? Here is 2 and 2, 3's are 6. It means 2 plus 6, 8. And 2 into 6, 12 is there. We can find out like this by factorizing the product of first into first and last coefficients. First of all, we have to find out the product of first and last coefficient, last constant term and coefficient of the first term. First term means the term which have high, which has highest degree. The term which has highest degree is the first term, and the constant term is the last term in these three terms. So first of all, multiply the coefficient of the first term, it means the term which has the highest degree, and the constant term. There will be 12, and factorize 12 like this, 2, 6, 2, 3. And from there, we have to find out two numbers. Among these three numbers, we have to find out two numbers whose sum is 8 and product is 12. Here is 2 into 3 is 6 and 2, 2. It means 2 plus 6, 8 and 2 into 6, 12. Now we have to write like this, x square plus 2 plus 6 x. 2 plus 6 x plus 12. It means x square plus 2 x plus 6 x plus 12. There is x common, x plus 2 plus 6 common, x plus 2. Here is x plus 2 and x plus 6. Next question is x square minus 15 x plus 56. Look here. In the similar way, first of all, what is the coefficient of the first term? It means the term which has the highest degree. 1. And what is the constant term? 56. Then multiply the coefficient of first term and the constant term is equal to 56. Is it? Next is, now we have to factorize it. 2, 28, 2, 14, 2, 7. Yes. Now we have to find out, in addition, we have to find out 15, and in product we have to find out 56. It means 2 to the 4 to the 8 plus 7 is equal to 15, and 8 into 7 is equal to 56. Yes, this is right. It means x square minus 8 plus 7 x plus 56. It is x square minus 8 x minus 7 x plus 56 is equal to x common x minus 8 minus 7 common x minus 8. Here is x minus 8 x minus 7. Among them, this is the factorization using first into last. In this part also, in this process also, there must be some clauses. One is here. When first and last terms are positive, ax square plus bx plus c. It means first and last terms are positive. It means 20x square plus 28x plus 9. First term and last term, both are positive. So, first of all, first multiplied for coefficient of first term and for constant term. First term means the term which has highest unit, and the constant is the term which has no variable. It means 20 into 980. Right? Here is 290, 245, 315, and 35. How can we do it? Look here. We have to find out in the sum, we have to bring 28, and in product, we have to bring 118. So look here. 3 3s are 9, 2s are 18, and 5 2s are 10 plus 10. 18 plus 10, 28, and 18 into 10, 180. One more thing, when first and last both terms are positive, then express the middle term in addition form. Look here, 20x square plus 28 means 18 plus 10 x plus 9. This is express the middle term. Middle term is expressed in the addition form. So 20x square plus 18x plus 10x plus 9. Look here. Here is 2x common, 10x plus 9 plus 1 common. There is no common between them, so 1 should be common. 10x plus 9 is equal to 10x plus 9, and here is 2x plus 1. Next concept is when first or last term is negative, express the middle term in subtraction form. For example, 4x square plus 5x minus 6. Here is, first term is positive but last term is negative. So, look at the board. Here is, first of all, we have to find out the product of first term, means the term which has highest degree, and the constant term. It means 4 into 6 minus 24. First of all, leave it minus. Factorizing 24. 2, 12, 2, 2, 6, 2, 3. Now we have to find out two numbers whose difference is 5, because last term is positive. Either first or last term is negative. Then express the middle term in subtraction form. From here, we have to determine that from which number which must be subtracted to bring the positive value 5. Look here, 2 to the 4 to the 8. 8 is here, and here is 3. 8 minus 3, how much? 5, and 8 into minus 3, how much? 8 into minus 3? 20, minus 24. Is it? Like this. Look here. 4x square plus 5x minus 6. Here, 4x square plus 8 minus 3x minus 6. Look. Last term is negative. So, here, we have expressed the middle term in subtraction form. Here is first or last term, both are positive, so we have expressed the middle term in addition form. So, here, 4x square plus 8x minus 3x minus 6. What should be the common? 4x, x plus 2 minus 3, x plus 2, is it? Here is x plus 2 common, x plus 2 common, here is 4x minus 3, is it? Right? Next question is 6 minus 35y minus 6y square. Next question is 6 minus 35y minus 6y square. Look here. This question is just reversed. Highest, the term which has highest degree is in the last, and the term which has no variable is in the first. It means constant term is in the first and first term is in the last. No way, no difficulty is there. First of all, multiply the constant term and the coefficient of first term. 6x minus 36, because here is minus 6 and here is 6. So minus 36, leave this minus, factorize 36. 2, 18, 2, 9, 3, 3. By seeing this question, this factorization cannot bear the result. Cannot bear the result, because multiplication of 6 and minus 6 is 36, and here is 35, just one less. So it's very simple. 36 minus 1 is equal to 35, because first or last, anyone term is negative, then we have to express the middle term in subtraction form. In that condition, 36 minus 1 is equal to 35, or 36 into minus 1 is equal to minus 36. It's very simple. So 6 minus 36 minus 1 y minus 6 y square. Okay. 6 minus 36 y plus y minus 6 y square. Look here, what should be the common? 6, 1 minus 6 y plus y common, 1 minus 6 y. Right? Here is 1 minus 6 y and 6 plus y. This is the factorization of first into last. Next is, factorization of the form a4 plus b4. How can we solve it? Look here. Suppose factorize this a4 plus b4. How can we factorize it? It is a square whole square plus b square whole square. It means a square plus b square whole square, it is in the form of a square plus b square. It means a plus b whole square minus 2ab, 2a square b square. Look here, a square plus b square whole square, a square and b square both are in a square form, but 2 is not in a square form. So we have to convert it in a square form. It means root 2ab whole square, because root 2 whole square means what? Look here, root 2 means here, what is the order over here? 2, it means 2 to the power, here is 1 by 2 whole to the power 2, it means 2, 1 by 2 into 2, that's cancelled, that is equal to 2. So root 2 square bears 2 only. Look here, a square plus b square, and this is in the form of a square minus b square. A square plus b square plus root 2ab, and a square plus b square minus root 2ab. Like this, we have to find out such type of factorization. Next question is 625 a4 plus 4b4. before. How can you solve this? Same similar way. 25 a square whole square, is it? Yes. Plus 4 b square whole square. Sorry, 2 b square whole square. Can we write? Again, it is in the form of a square plus b square. So 25 a square plus 2 b square whole square, right? Minus 2 a. A means 25 a square. B means 2 b square. Right? Next is 25 a square plus 2 b square whole square minus 25 to the 50 to the 100 a square b square. Yes. Here is 100 is also in perfect square. A square and b square are also in perfect square. So 25 a square plus 2 b square whole square minus 10 a b whole square. Right? So it is in the form of a square minus b square. What is the formula? A square minus b square. A plus b into a minus b. It means 25 a square plus 2 b square plus 10 a b and 25 a square plus 2 b square minus 10 a b. This is the factorization. Next form of factorization is factorization of the form a whole plus a square b square plus b whole. A whole plus a square b square plus b whole. Look at example. First of all, factorize this a4 plus a square b square plus b. Look here. Put them both the quartic term. Quartic term is the term which has degree 4. It means biquadratic. By next name of biquadratic is quartic. Q-U-A-R-T-I-C, quartic form. Put the quartic form of the terms which has power 4 put together. A4 plus B4 plus A square B square. It means A square whole square plus B square whole square plus A square B square. Look here. A square plus B square whole square. Next is minus 2AB. Minus 2 into a square into b square plus a square b square, right as it is. Look here, a square plus b square whole square. When we subtract from minus 2ab square and a square b square, it will be minus a square b square. It is a square plus b square whole square and it is ab whole square. It means a square plus b square and it is in the form of a square minus b square plus ab and here is a square plus b square minus ab. We can write like this: a square plus ab plus b square, a square minus ab plus b square. Right? Next form is, question is, suppose here is a4 minus 15 a square b square plus 8b question 8 x4 plus 6x square y square plus 25y4. How can we solve this? Same way, put the quartic terms together. X square whole square up plus 25y square whole square and this is 6x square y square. Right? Look here. A plus b whole square minus 2 A means x square, B means 5y square plus 6x square y square, right hand. It means x square plus 5y square whole square, it is 5 to the 10x square y square plus 6x square y square. When we subtract 6x square y square from 10x square y square, what will be there? Minus 4x square y square, because sine of minus 10x square y square is bigger than the sine of 6x square y square, right? So x square plus 5y square whole square, sorry, 5y square whole square minus 4x square y square, it means x square plus 5y square whole square minus 2xy whole square, right? So x square plus 5y square plus 2xy and x square plus 5y square minus 2xy, is it? Okay, in the next class we will continue the other types of factorization, and there should be some random questions also. All these random questions and other type of factorization we will discuss. After that we will start HCF and LCM, because first, for the studying of HCF and LCM, we have to know how to factorize the trinomials or polynomials. Then only we can solve highest common factor and lowest common multiple. So read your book, open your book. There will be some exercise for the factorization. Try to do the questions. If there will be some problem, then put the question in the Siddharth web page. Hopefully, I will solve this. Okay, thank you.